Hello everyone, Thranxes here, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, episode 20, where we are working on this pit. Oh no, RJ somehow ended up down here, and we need to get him out. So let's do that. Please and thank you. There we go. Okay, now he can get out. So this is ultimately temporary. My thought process is that this is going to be kind of a place to kick the excess polluted water while we figure out just exactly how we're gonna, you know, convert it into clean water. Now we can run a filtration system. We do have a good bit of sand. Actually, that might be the smartest way to go about it, but I want to repurpose this into more bedrooms. That's, oh, weaswort seed. Oh, speaking of, this one got picked up right. So, as I noticed, my seed got picked up because, yes, because this storage here is holding on to seeds. So we're going to leave those two in there for now. There we go. Oh, what is that? Okay. Not a seed that we care about. This area looks like it's starting to... It's getting there. It's getting there. It'll be good soon. Once the power is running again. But let's get this area cooled off. That's my big thing. We need to get this area a lot colder. Polluted atmosphere? What? Well, we'll have to fix that. Yes, perfect. And you're gonna need sand, so you can be a 9. Let's speed things up and let people get some work done. Oh, there we go. Foxheart's gonna deliver the weaswort seed. Times 2, thank you. Now you can drop those. And deconstruct the box there. And then we need to put our other box back over here. A little bit of back and forth. So now all three seeds are there. Son of a. It's not how I wanted that to go. Oh well, that's fine. We'll wait for that one to be planted. And then... Well, they're getting colder. Just not cold enough yet. Well, that one said refrigerated for a second. Still not sure how that's working. Okay, a new duplicant. No, we're still working on the bedroom area here. So what we can do is we can get rid of this. You're no longer going in that direction. In fact, this one single fertilizer machine isn't really handling the amount of contaminated water that we have. So this is going to have to be relocated as well. That's okay. Not a problem. Alright. So now what we can do... Oh, yeah. Might have dug a little too close to that water there. That's going to break. Well, this will fill up quicker than I had anticipated then. What are you coming in here for? Oh, you're just sorting stuff into boxes. That's fine. Not a huge deal. All right, so we've got our temperature going in here. Look at this! Thimbleweed and such. Great. Great, great, great. Let's go ahead and... We'll throw you here, and we'll get some decor. Let's use the granite. Yep. There. And then I'm going to have a storage compactor for the thimbleweed. Here. Here is fine. So then what we'll do is we'll come down here, and we'll provide a door. That'll work. That will work. Still not as warm in there as it should be. Now why is this water, it seems like this water doesn't want to fill up even though there's all this water over here. Eventually I would like to stop pumping water into this room, although it appears like everything is growing just fine. I don't know. I'm not sure. Where are you going, Ken? I'm very sorry you don't have a bedroom yet. Oh, sleeping right in front of the outhouse. I know. I know. It's gotta be frustrating. Oh, no! No, no, no. Okay, pick all that up, and then this is gonna get locked. That's gonna be a whole lot of water. As a 9, let's lock this thing now. Nobody needs to go in there. I have a bad feeling about that. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of polluted water coming down that way. Speaking of, polluted water is gonna have nowhere to go. Oh, I know what we can do. We'll just do this, right? We'll dig out this way. And we'll go ahead and say manual airlock. We can go right here, sure. And then what we'll do is we'll take all of this excess dirty water that we're not yet ready to handle, but we will soon. And we'll just put it right out here and add it to all of this. Sure thing. Let's get it done. And then we can tap this into that, which let's go ahead and make that a reality. So we can clear out all this water in here. It's not a lot, but we do want to clear it up. Question is, which power grid do we want to tap into? This is having a hard enough time staying running. This is going to be maxed out. 240. It's already... Yeah, it's already kind of capped, so we can't pull off of that circuit. This one, we can pull off of this one. Because this isn't going to run all the time anyways. And then this will be just for reed fiber. Wonderful. At an 8, let's make that an 8. So this over here, food shortage? There's no food shortage. How are we doing with temperature over here? Yeah, they're getting cold, just not cold enough. Carbon dioxide there is, for some reason, really warm. Look at that, 18°C. Well, it's cooling off. Is it because we have this... Why is this warm? Is this thing... This thing is producing heat. Is that what it is? No, not really, but the sand being put in it is warm. Because the air deodorizer itself is pretty cold. Well, getting there. More wheezewurts is probably going to be the answer. That'll help. We need to get this area cooled off, or keeping it nice and cool. Yeah, this water is what, warming up? Ugh. Gonna be difficult. All right, let's get this thing situated here. So I think what we're gonna do here is we're gonna tap off of... Yeah, we're gonna tap off of this current, because it's just, or this circuit, it's just temporary. Not a huge deal, but we do want to get it done. And then the pipe will go just like that. And then all of the dirty water can just be piped into here. Oh, look at that. That's interesting. And then we're going to move this as well. So let's do that. You know what we're going to need, though? We're going to need another air deodorizer over here. Running out of oxygen. Yeah, we're going to kick on this air scrubber in just a minute. Just a minute. Not yet. Not quite. But instead, we're going to go ahead and break these. I think that's appropriate. As soon as this thing starts taking up polluted water, it's going to run into a problem. Oh, and look, we got this clean water down here. How's the oxygen doing? Oxygen system seems to be doing just fine. Now, it's not really cooled off. In hindsight, I would have liked to have put some wheezewarts in here. Would have helped keep everything nice and cool. Yeah, look, we got this warm air coming off of these batteries here. Well, hindsight's 20/20. Get these last few bits done here, get this pipe going, and then all of that polluted water can go. Because what, this lavatory is not in use, this one's got a blocked pipe, so everybody's having to use the outhouse. Oof, yes, we do have a food shortage. So all of our food has been used. So now we're going to have to harvest. There we go. Now we have plenty of fertilizer for the time being. We have plenty of sand, so we're going to need to start filtering this water eventually until we are set up to do a steam system, which is my end game. That's where I would like to be eventually. Again, the sand inside of this is not very cold. Trying to keep this whole area nice and cold. But it seems to be significantly warmer near these oxygen deodoriters. No, there's a lot of warmth right here. Yeah, warm air over there. Everybody's kind of overheated, but unrefrigerated, sterile atmosphere. We have to see how that goes when we get another one going. I don't know if they would do better spread out. It's very cold over here, but I don't know. I feel like I chased the cold in, and then it just brought more heat with it. The problem is the food is coming from an area where it's at a warm temperature. Yep, hold on. This pump is stopped for some reason. Out of power. That will do it. That will do it. So this generator needs to run. And it's not producing enough, I don't think. It sure isn't. Okay, so we're going to need another one. Here. Which can be priority 9. Yep. And then we'll get somebody running on that. All these manual generators. We're going to have to set up coal eventually. Going to be mandatory type of situation, but what I would like to do is I would like to start expanding outward. This area, oh, see, that's exactly why I wanted my cistern just to be too wide, was because otherwise you end up with this awkward scenario where it takes time for the water to flow over to the pump. Same over here. Generator idle, please kick that on and then enable this building as well, please. There we go, we are now generating power, and we're consuming carbon dioxide. And then all that dirty water goes to one place. Out that way, which means these are working again. Excellent. Excellent. That's good. Oxygen generation. Still making a lot of oxygen. If we could keep the batteries full, I'm sure the oxygen would last a lot longer. Hey, we have textiles and what? We have some reed fibers. And we're ready to harvest more. Let's do that. Oh, look. This room is running beautifully. Okay. But we don't need that water pipe anymore. The tiles are fully submerged. I don't know how important that it was to fully submerge them because it seemed like they were working just fine, but it says it needs to be submerged. I wanted to submerge it. There we go. Okay. That'll work. We can get all that stuff back. go ahead and harvest this one as well. And now over here, we can start fabricating stuff. Oh, this is wonderful. So over here, we're also going to, well, we'll do that. So let's make, well, I imagine we're going to want enough of each of them. Let's make a few snazzy suits. How about that? There it goes. Excellent. I love it. This pump is going to take forever to relocate this water, too. I just know it. So we'll get our tile there. And then we're also going to get an air deodorizer there. All right. Eventually, this area will get straightened out. This is probably not necessary anymore. We can also, we're going to block this up for now so that we can dig this out and get some of this water down in there. Then I think we're going to have to start considering some hardcore water filtration. But look at all this polluted water we have here. And we're going to need an air deodorizer over here as well. That's fine. There it goes. Water is flowing. Hey, we're getting some clean water into our dirty water mixture now. That is excellent. Which means we'll start filling up the cistern some more. Yep, there you go. Still should be making plenty of oxygen. Should be looking at a net gain. Not a net loss. Are they reaching max gas pressure? They are, too. You know, I suppose I could... Well, no, because I don't have... You have to have natural soil to plant the weezwort. You can't put it in a planter box, unfortunately. Not yet, anyways. I imagine that'll get fixed eventually. Hey, look at that. Snazzy suits. Well, let's put those clothes in here, please. Look at that. All right, we'll remove those. Okay, so who's stressed? Nobody's really stressed. Well, Wildrage is. Well, Wildrage, you get the very first bit of clothing. Signed suit. Duplicate has not been assigned a suit. I would like to assign you a suit. Clothes? Okay, well, let's check out the duplicants. We'll do that first. 10 digging! Tempted. Destructive, though. No, not yet. Not yet. Not just yet. Okay, so we are in the net gain of oxygen. So that's good. And we have good oxygen concentration everywhere here. And what we're going to do is we're going to tile down like this and create a door. And then to facilitate airflow, we're going to need some of these gas permeable tiles like this and like that. And then we'll just wait for this thimble reed stuff to keep being made. We'll make a few extra suits. Right, the suits. Let's not get distracted. Okay, Wildrage, how can we... Clinic, leisure area, unassigned, suit, unassigned. But what if I want to assign you a suit? That's the question. Primarily made of ooze, mass, heat, thermal conductivity. Perhaps we just need to... Yes, equip snazzy suit. Wildrage. That is great. Go ahead and get that. Just to increase the decor. once you're done on the hamster wheel, of course. I'm sure that's more important at this current stage. Alright, so we're getting rid of this carbon dioxide. That's good. Filling this area up with all of our filthy polluted water. Just cranking it out. Showers and lavatories running. Okay, excellent. So now what do we have? We have all of this over here. We have more weezwort. Has this one been planted yet? Where are you? No! No! Unacceptable. Those seeds are never going to plant themselves. Absolutely horrible. Horrible, I say. Seed, and that'll work. Okay. Plus, we can cancel the sweeping. It's not important. All right. Done with the seeds. Deconstruct. Okay. Now what we can do also, though, is we can say... We'll do a little bit of gas permeable tile there just to help that out. Unrefrigerated. Minus 15.7C, and it's unrefrigerated. I have no idea what's going on with that. Like, just absolutely none. It's incredibly cold here. But it's because carbon dioxide in this area isn't cold. That's what I'm guessing. The carbon dioxide here is not cold. And why it's not cold, I do not know. And polluted atmosphere. How is that possible? I've got these air deodorizers. My goodness. This is going to have to be some kind of hermetically sealed environment. That's what it's going to be. So the oxygen here is incredibly cold. We just need more of them. I'm guessing that's all it is. We need more weezworts. Hopefully this one will get planted before too long. All right. Still showing a net gain on the oxygen. Water tank is filling up faster than it's emptying. Everything is right in the world. So, let's go up here. It's time to expand. We're going to expand upward a bit. And I think for now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and... how can we do this? Oh, look at that. A morb. Wonderful. Well, we're not there yet. Let's go ahead and I want to start processing slime at some point. Or do I? Yes, I do. It would make more sense to do it down here, though. Well, maybe not. There's not really... The slime biomes are kind of in... it would make sense to do it over this way, actually. Yeah, it would. It really, really would. Okay. How's the air scrubber doing? The air scrubber is... Oh, no! Ken contracted hypothermia by extreme internal temperature. Is it that chilly down here? Surely not. What? Oh, no. That's horrible. Duplicant's thought process have been slowed to a crawl by the terrible cold. Contracted by extreme internal temperature. Is your temperature really that? That's odd. Okay, I don't think that's how that was supposed to go. All right, we'll disable this building. That'll save on some power, and then we'll just keep pumping this dirty water out. Which, it's not even pumping anything, it's just... Yeah, this is horrible. This is exactly why I don't want a cistern that's wide, because you get this horrible phenomenon here. Where it's just like, this water does not... It refuses to flow. Okay. So, here's how we're going to handle this. We're going to go ahead and say, all of this is done. And this is done. To be fair, first I would like to just mop up all this water. I know it's kind of wasteful, but at this point, this pump isn't doing what it's supposed to do. Let's just get rid of it, everybody. There you go. Deconstruct the whole shebang. And then buildings, we'll deconstruct these. Oh no! Don't roll your ankle. Good night. Okay, now let's get ourselves another bedroom, shall we? We'll do the gas permeable tile. Right, we'll go two down here and there. Just like that. With our doors. Well, we'll let them destroy what they've got. Okay, the door. And then we'll do gas permeable here. And actually, these should be gas permeable. I don't know why they're not, but we'll do that. So we'll cancel you and then get our gas permeable tiles here, here, and here. That'll work. All right, good. Now we'll get some more cots in place. We'll do granite here and there. And for the decor, we'll do sculpting out of granite. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, of course, the canvas here and there. And then we'll set up the gas pipe. Do I really want... It should come from here, really. But that's... See, because if this one's backing up, then to facilitate airflow... I'm thinking... To facilitate airflow, this one should really come down, but that's... I don't know if I want to do that. That's a lot of piping. I think what we'll just do is we'll just stick with this for now. Do the gas vent. We'll just do that. For now. Alright, we've got more carbon dioxide. Let's turn this building back on, please. Make sure we didn't interfere with any pipes, which it doesn't look like we did. We still have all kinds of polluted water going over there. Oof, this door. Yeah, that door's gonna have to stay shut for a bit. It's not going to be usable, not anytime soon. Oh, look at that. Look at how fast they can get stuff accomplished when they work together. I love it. Are you holding your breath? Is the air that bad in there? Really? Well, we're gonna need to get some more air circulation, probably. Polluted oxygen up in there. I don't like that. Well, we'll get some of the CO2 scrubbed out of the air here. Boy, these batteries just cannot handle the workload being put on them through the night. Not at all. Although the air concentration's pretty good. Well, sort of good. I say that. And then, of course, we've got all kinds of carbon dioxide trickling into this room here. Low concentration of oxygen down here. Because what we need... I wonder if I can run this pump down into there. Let's see what happens if I do that. I'm not sure how that's going to go. Let's see what happens now. I have no idea how that's going to work. But we're going to experiment. We're going to figure it out. Because if it would... Well, I don't know how it's going to treat each intersection. Oh, No, see, that's not how I want that to go. Well, we could deconstruct that and leave it on this pipe, but this pipe isn't getting as much oxygen as this one. This one's getting twice as much oxygen because of the intersection that I worked out here. Right, so let's go ahead and break those. That's how we'll do that. Because this is gonna. Yeah, there you go. See, now this oxygen that's doubled up here. So this is because this pipe always flows in the direction of the pressure every single time. And this one alternates. So this pipe gets 1.5 times the oxygen that it normally would, and this one gets half as much as it normally would. And over time, as this pipe backs up, this pipe should get just incredibly full of oxygen. That was working earlier, so let's set it up like that. Let's let it run like that for a bit. All right, at this point we can go ahead and break that. That's fine. Cold. Because of the water. The water is what's making you cold. A duplicate. 9 digging, but can't build. And you're destructive. No. Not today, not today. Wow. Water tank's starting to really fill up. That's neat. Good stuff. Good stuff indeed. Well, we are going to have to start finding ways to get clean water back over here. So I think what we can do is we can go ahead and build this ladder up like this. And then what we can do is we can go ahead and dig all this out, and dig that out, and then that, and then that. We need the copper anyways. So that'll work. Everybody can kind of just hop around on those ladders there. Yeah, look at that. Wonderful. So now we're adding fresh water back to our pool. The dirty water will eventually be filtered out. The CO2 scrubber is still scrubbing CO2 out of the air, so that's good. How's our oxygen concentration doing? It's getting there. Now, if I added more gas permeable tiles, I could influence the airflow between rooms, but it would hurt the decor. I'd rather keep the decor up if able. If able. And these batteries, they don't. Oh, they are running all night. Look at that. Okay, so that time they did run all night. And it still takes us a little bit for the oxygen generation to catch up because they're still hitting maximum gas pressure in this chamber. Yeah. I don't know, we might be reaching the point where three electrolyzers just aren't enough. Which, if that's the case, we're gonna have to start brainstorming a way to unrefrigerated food still. Where is my weaseswort seed? Oh my goodness. Are you kidding me? Stop storing these seeds. Wait. You're storing seeds. Not authorized. Go through and check them all. Wait. Are you serious? No. Okay. So, I wish you could just copy paste. You could just say, I want to take the settings of this one box and copy paste them to these boxes. That would make life a little easier. Okay, so now we have to start the process of this wheezewort being planted all over again. Let's cancel that one. If we're going to do it, we should do it over here, I'm thinking. Although that says oxygen is cold and it's refrigerated. This one, the oxygen is at 10, 11, 12. Well, it's getting colder over time. This one is refrigerated right here. Yep, that oxygen's pretty cold, so it's refrigerated. Well, I think more Weezwurts will do the trick. But we'll have to wait and see, I suppose. How are we doing for fertilizer? Fertilizer, we're doing good. Filtration medium's doing good. I think at this point, let's make a cool vest and a warm sweater. And we'll store the clothes in there. That sounds good. Oh, yeah. We never checked out Wildrage. Wildrage's got new digs. Let's do that. Oh, yeah, there you go. A snazzy vest. Projecting that decor. And look at that. The stress is reduced for everyone. All right. There we go. Stacy's knitting the cool vest. That'll work. Excellent. I think we're gonna set up our slime factories and fertilizer and everything right over here in this section. I think that would make the most sense. And what we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to start excavating down and clearing all of this out. That's what we're going to have to do. So we'll get that going. And did we get our Weezwort seed over here? No, we did not. Right. So can we please bring it over here now? The Weezwort seed. Please. I would really love to get this area colder. So this ration box is fully refrigerated. No! No! It changed ever so slightly. And this one's still unrefrigerated because it's got oxygen at a very cold temperature. No, 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 no. Stop. Just stop. It's moving all the seeds over there. I should have known better. Should have been specific. Ration box is completely refrigerated. This one, yeah, not so much. Well, it's trying. It's trying really hard to stay refrigerated. It is, to its credit. I don't really like this slope down effect here. I don't think that's very good. That's unreachable. Okay, and I'm running over my time again. But that's where we're going to wrap things up. This has been Oxygen Not Included, episode 20. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had a good time watching, because as always, I've had a good time playing. So come back next time and check out as we get our slime fertilizer area set up here and potentially the water filtration. I don't know if we're going to go that way right away, but we will at some point. But at the very least, we're going to get our slime area set up, which means we're going to need more power, which means we're going to have to figure out another circuit. So we're probably going to end up moving batteries over here. And yeah, I think this abyssalite will protect this ice from being warmed up too much. But until then, take care.